is Vihang, guys. Redox here, and well, disclaimer, before I posted this video, I posted something called Spirits Trailer. Don't expect anything. It was just a trial. There's gonna be nothing is gonna be uploaded in April because I have school, and well, this is probably the last video of the year. I mean, like, for this month, the next video is gonna be most probably in October or November, depends on when it is. So don't expect a regular upload schedule. I can't do that. I can't commit to anything. So before going on to the video, I just want to tell everybody what topic this video is. This video is on how to get better footage out of your smartphone. You see, smartphones are slowly replacing all devices. They have replaced camcorders, they have replaced cameras, like actual cameras, they have replaced MP3 players. But it was never made for professional or even good-looking video use. But you can help increase that. I mean, as a matter of fact, this video right now is filmed on a smartphone. So it was filmed on a Samsung Galaxy S7 Edge. It was a top-of-the-line smartphone, but now it's gotten a bit old, but still is very capable. Smartphones were never made for video. They have very small sensors and they get extremely grainy under low light. These tips I'm going to be telling you are going to help avert that and make your videos slash home videos look a bit more presentable or slash professional. See, first of all, I suggest, I mean, all smartphone cameras have this. Go to your camera app, go to the settings, and there'll be something called grid. Enable that. Whoa, suddenly there's like two horizontal and two vertical lines over here on your video. I don't want it on my videos. It's not going to be on your videos. It's just for the preview. This grid is called the rule of thirds. These two horizontal and vertical lines, they divide the view into 9 equal halves. And these lines intersect at 4 distinct points. Those intersecting points are the best places to frame your subject. If you can't frame them at the intersection points, frame them on either one of the horizontal or vertical lines. It's going to be helping you to get a better look out of it. Our brains are tied to, subconsciously they search for subjects in these specified locations. So it would be better if you would frame your subjects on the intersection points. So once you've done that, you automatically notice that your videos or photos look better. They start to look better, and well, that's the starting point. So if you want to further improve on it, you have to get manual control on your smartphones. Like if you're using phones from Xiaomi, Samsung, Nokia, they actually provide camera apps with manual control. You have utmost control over your smartphone camera, so you can make it to do the best it can. But if you don't have it, I suggest you download this app called Open Camera. It's an open source camera and it actually has all the manual controls you want. Its UI is a bit clunky, but once you get used to it, it's actually good. And it also has manual features for video, and most smartphones don't offer that. In almost every sort of video, on every sort of camera you take, there has to be certain rules to be followed. There's a certain rule called the 180 degree shutter rule. I'm not going to go into the specifics, but what it says is that if your shutter speed, once you get into the manual settings controls, you'll see something called the shutter speed. The shutter speed is video is just a bunch of still frames, and the frequency that the camera takes the still frames at is called shutter speed. So the higher the shutter speed, the less blurring it will be, and your videos will appear more what, action movie or like something that is very dramatic. If you want something to feel natural, it has to be twice the frame rate. The frame rate of your video most probably 30 frames per second. But in open camera, if you're following along, the option to shoot at 24 frames per second. The most cinematic motion is on 24 frames per second because all your Hollywood major productions, they're all shot on 24 frames per second. So once you start filming at 24, everything starts to look more professional. And if you're following the 180 degree shutter rule, it has to be 1 over 48th or 1 over 50th because 24 into 2 is 48.
Minus 1, that's free quick maths.
So the shutter speed has to be 1 50th of a second. That will give you the most natural motion blur. Once you do that, your video is going to be either overexposed or underexposed. If it's underexposed, you have to increase the ISO to a level to which it looks good. And for smartphones, I suggest you don't go above 400. So what is ISO? ISO is basically, to put it in simple words, the amount, how sensitive your sensor is to light. So you'd want it to be as high as possible, right? No, you actually don't want it to be as high as possible. You want it to be as low as possible. Increasing ISO results in noisy images, and you don't want noisy images because it'll totally make your video look amateur and look bad. So film in 24 FPS, use twice your frame rate as shutter speed and use the lowest ISO possible. After this, you have to consider getting a tripod to stabilize your video so that it doesn't end up being constantly shaky and ruin your video. So get a tripod. I have an Amazon Basics $50 tripod, and it's served me really well for this 2 years. So next comes audio. Most people will rank lighting above audio, but I rank audio above lighting, because people will watch a bad video with a very low resolution with really good audio, but they will not watch a 4K video with crap audio. Your smartphone was not built for video, as I said, and it's also not built for audio. If I were to use the microphone on my phone right now, the phone that is recording, my video would sound like this. This isn't a very flattering look, and you wouldn't want this. So you can clearly see I'm wearing a mic. It'd be like that is a Sennheiser mic, or like that's a very expensive mic. No, that is a $1 mic of Amazon, and it is doing this job very well. It's how you use it, it's not what you have. So what I'm doing is I have another phone, the Nokia 5 in this case, recording the audio of this mic right now. And what it is doing is it's recording to it, and I'm going to sync it in while editing. This is too much for a normal person. It's because I am mad, so don't do this. You can connect this straight to your phone. It's just a headphone jack that is going into the phone. So this can instantly improve your video quality by helping your voice come out a bit better instead of the background overpowering your audio. See, I have certain things going on. There's a fan going on. There's a inverter going on that side. There's a light here. It creates some frequency of sound and it all interferes, but this helps cut it out. So the next thing is audio, and if you're following along, you bought this mic, you have it covered. I'd have it linked down below. I'm not sure this exact mic is available. I will link a similar mic in the description below. Check it out. Next comes lighting. So lighting is one of the things you have to essentially have. Without light, you can't have video. So what I'm doing right now is I'm sitting next to a window, so there is natural light coming into my face. But if I do it like this, it becomes too dark on this side. Let me just go over and switch off the light. If I turn off that light, this part of my face becomes completely dark. So I look like a villain or like a bad guy. I guess a bad guy is a villain. So I look like a villain, and I don't want that. I want to appear friendly, and I want to appear like a person who can legitimately help you. So this is not a good look. This is very soft light and it creates a good impression, but there's too much of darkness on you. I should be like this to look for it to look better, but I can't talk like this. Would this look natural to you? No, this won't. Let me just go back and turn on the light again. It looks too dark. So now with this light, there's some light filling this side, so I look evenly lit and I'm not looking like a villain of a movie right now. So lighting is not very expensive. All I'm using is a work light with some paper on top of it for diffusion to not make it as harsh. So that's it. I'm using the sun and one $20 work light, and this is the result you can get out of it. So lighting is a very complex topic, but simply, like, you have to have your main source of light or your key light off to like 45 or 50 degrees off of your camera. You don't have to measure it. It approximately has to be like this way, and it has to hit your face. And because you want that much of shadows, you want a fill light to fill in the shadows that is not too bright. So you have to have just a key or a main light and a fill light to help even your face out. And this is basic lighting covered. I mean, there's a lot of other different lighting techniques that they use in major productions, but that is not needed to make your videos look good. A simple key and a fill will get you a long way. So we have covered one of thirds, the 180 degree shutter roll, shutter speed should be twice the frame rate. We have covered white shot in 24 frames per second. We have also covered lighting and audio, and also stabilization in the form of a tripod. So this is all you need to make a good looking video on YouTube, to stand out on YouTube amongst all the other channels. Next, you have already done this and your videos look good. So what else can you do? You can try different framing methods. There's depth of field involved. If you can get the background out of focus, do that. And if you can get something to obstruct the camera slightly to get some sort of a foreground element that is out of focus, it also helps in increasing the presentability level of your video. And if you've done all that and you have nothing else to do, you can install the app I'm using right now, that is Cinema 4K. It costs 240 rupees. The dollar conversion will be on top, laid on top. It is actually, it doesn't require you to buy it off the bat. It is a free app for starters, but it can only show it for 1 minute. If you want more than 1 minute videos, you have to buy the app. It offers you manual controls. It offers you flat picture profiles. Flat video looks like this. So why should my videos be in flat? Well, your videos, it makes it look worse, right? See, having flat video is basically like having a blank canvas. You can edit however you want. So if I have this right now, I could color grade it in my computer on using software that is DaVinci Resolve to get this look. And well, if it was normal video, I wouldn't be able to do this. So you can customize how the way it looks using color grading, or you can, if it's too hard for you, you can use LUTs, that is lookup tables. They're just presets for your video. So by using these tips, your videos can go a long way, and you don't need to have a masterclass. You don't need to go through a masterclass or have a diploma in filmmaking to do these. These are simple tips. So that's it. The video is over. Don't expect upload schedule from me, because this year, 2019 to 2020, my school is going to be very hard on me. So I don't expect a lot of videos. There's going to be very erratic, random uploads. So I'm sorry for that. Maybe with the next year, by 2020, I would try to get a proper upload schedule going. But it's like that. I'm sorry for everybody who was expecting a video and didn't get a video. It's just how my things are going on. I don't have enough time to properly do whatever I want to do. Anything I do, I want it to be absolutely perfect, and nothing comes out perfect when you don't have enough time. So I need some time, and well, if you don't get a video when you wanted it to, I'm sorry for that, I'd say. So this is Redox, I'm Pranav, and follow this channel more for more filmmaking tips or tech reviews. So yeah, thanks for watching, and this is Redox signing off.